So this is how you're going to fix lag inside of Grow a Garden. So obviously inside of Grow a Garden, if you do have, you know, a bunch of crap in your plot or in your inventory, you can experience high lag. And just in general, you can run into lag. Now, this is a super big issue because I even had people whine and complain because they had so much lag, they couldn't even load into the game. Like the game would crash or their computer just couldn't even handle it because they had so much crap having to run. So like if you do the tomato strat, which is currently the best way you can do the summer harvest event, you probably can't even do it because there's just so many plants. Now, the reason why this is a bit annoying is considering the fact that this is super helpful for grinding the summer harvest, but it does create a lot of lag because I have like 700 plants right here. Now, what you can do, there are two methods you can do to fix lag. One of them I'll go over later, which will like almost guarantee fixing your lag because it'll go into information in regards to your actual device and how you can increase performance on things you didn't even realize on like task manager and computer settings. But alongside that, we have also the in general stuff. So for the most part, if you do want to win the giveaway, I'm giving away a bunch of seed packs and premium Oasis eggs. So to enter into the giveaway, all you got to do is comment your username on this video and like this video. And then once again, you'll be entered into the Oasis premium egg giveaway and the exotic summer seed pack giveaway. So once again, just subscribe and comment your username and like this video. So starting off, one of the main issues, as I said before, that'll cause lag and build up is just a lot of data on your account. So obviously the server's going to have to load in all this information. And you're actively running along with, so if your inventory's full, you're actively running along with a ton of crap in your account. So this is going to actively increase lag and usually high delay. And this can easily lead to crashing if your device is not capable of loading this. So what you can do to fix this is, for the most part, obviously, you know, if you want to clear out your inventory or if you have a bunch of pets and items you don't want to get rid of, you can load these onto alt accounts. Now, you can easily join on like your phone and stuff like that. Or you can just load them in other ways using emulators if you don't have a phone. And you can do stuff like that. But you can offload all of your items onto an alt account just to make sure that you actually have less items that the game has to run. Now, for the most part, obviously, you can, you know, come up into Roblox and you can turn down graphic settings. And then you can also, if you do this, you can set up your frame rate. So I have this set to the default because I'm running this on a laptop right now, not my usual computer. Usually I'll do 240 just because it's the max and it looks nice. But for the most part, this is something to note is you want to make sure that this setting is messed with. Another thing to note with this graphic settings, a lot of times people mess up the automatic and manual. Manual forces it to set to a certain level. So if I set it to the lowest, it's going to stay at the lowest. But if you set it to the highest, it'll stay at the highest. Now, automatic is going to automatically go up and down continuously because pretty much what's going to happen is it's going to constantly adjust your graphics level depending on what it thinks your device can handle. So the reason why this is a bit tedious is because it will constantly be going up and down, right? This can create lag in itself, but it's also unstable. So if you do want to just do this setting, just make sure you set your graphics all the way down to one on the manual setting, and then that'll be pretty decent. Now, the next thing we're going to look at is your actual device and how you can increase it there. So if you are on Windows, you can click Control, Shift, and Escape, or just search Task Manager, and we'll open up Task Manager. Now, you're going to come on over to Details right here, and you're going to search Roblox. Now, what we're going to do is what's called setting the priority of the game. So you're going to right-click on it and set priority. So usually, it'll always be set to normal depending on the thing it's running now. What this does is it pretty much, if you change the priority, it's going to change it and how your computer prioritizes running the software. So if you're running Roblox at normal priority, it's going to prioritize running Roblox normally. But if you have something else that's more system heavy, like that requires more RAM or VRAM, this is going to use that instead and you're going to lose performance over in Roblox. So once again, what you can do, this will be applicable to genuinely anything. You can right click on it and then you're going to come on down to set priority and you're going to set this to high. So make sure though, once you do this, it's going to warn you that if you change priority, it can become unstable in your systems because once again, it's going to prioritize running Roblox the fastest it can rather than the other applications. Now, the reason it's default is normal is because once again, it wants to run everything the way it wants to, but if you're only doing Roblox, it really does not matter. You're going to right click on Roblox, set priority and set it to high and then change priority. And then Roblox is going to automatically just after a moment of loading, it's going to start running a lot faster. Now, the reason why is it's going to start prioritizing running Roblox at a higher efficiency using more, you know, RAM, VRAM, and it's going to prioritize giving more performance and system priority on the application. Now, this can be used for any other tasks. If you're running like an editor or other things, you can use this same system to do this. But one thing you should note is what this can do and go wrong is if you don't have the device capabilities to do this. So say you don't have a lot of RAM, like 4 or something, and you're on a lower end device. What this can do is, the reason why it gives you that warning is you can actually start to see a lot of instability because what can happen is it'll start not having enough resources to run other applications like Microsoft Defender or just in general processes, and these will start to lag. And the reason why you do want to make sure you can check this is you can go over back onto Task Manager and you can go over to performance. Now on performance, you can see your individual things. So I can see my CPU, all of this stuff. So this laptop I'm using right now has 32 gigabytes of RAM. So it'll be able to dedicate 32 gigabytes of RAM and it'll prioritize using that RAM to the top capabilities on Roblox rather than, you know, just giving it, you know, a few gigabytes to run well. This is very applicable to help fix lag, but obviously if you don't have the device capabilities, it won't work. And another issue you could run into is you can't find Roblox. So when you're on details and you can't find Roblox, if you search it, what you have to note is Roblox has to be open for this to work. So obviously you can't search Roblox in the details page unless Roblox is actively open. So do make sure if you can't find Roblox that you at least have Roblox, you know, open.